Hare Krishna, we are once again blessed to get an opportunity to entertain the holy Vaishnava audience. Today, we are depicting the glorious pastimes of Thirumangai.
Didi, who is Thirumangai?
Ladini, he is one of the 12 Alvars of South India. He is also known as Kalidhvamsa. Kalidhvamsa means the destroyer of the influence of Kali.
We do dramas to get inspired and follow in the footsteps of great devotees. It is so exciting, Didi. What happened?
This puts me in great confusion today. How are we going to follow Thirumangai?
But why, Didi? Please tell me. Tell me the pastime of Thirumangai, Didi. Please tell me.
So you want to join me in my big confusion?
Yes.
So be it. Many years ago, when Bharat was not just a country on the world map, but the entire planet Earth, it was also called Ilavarth. It was so beautiful that damsels from the heavens came down for bathing in the ponds here.
Oh Sundari, you attract everyone in the court of Devendra. But while playing with us, you become a shrewd cheater.
Cheater? I did not cheat. You fell short of words.
Enough of your quarrels. Girls, play some nice game. How about Krishna Leela?
I will play Krishna. What about you? Try Kamsa. You will fit well.
I will play Yashoda so that I can discipline you.
But Sakhi, we would like to hear from you. Your singing brings everyone to life.
Yes, Sakhi.
Please sing for us, Sakhi. Please, please.
ಮದ ಮದ ನಿಸ ನಿಗರಿ ನಿಸದ ನಿಸರಿ ಸರಿ 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 ಸರಿ
crying here. Look, what an unfortunate sight. An unprotected girl in a forest. Putri, Govinda. This girl cannot be from this world.
Kaki, I have lost my way to Amravati.
Amravati? Amravati... Amravati, the abode of Indra.
Yes, Kaki. Please help me. Please help me.
Putri, my husband is a simple Vaidya. He cannot take you to heavens.
Putri, don't worry. But you can stay here with us.
And as soon as your friends come again here, you may return back with them.
Thank you. Thank you, Kaki ji. Thank you, Kaka ji.
But you will have to be very careful, my child. And you must not play alone outside in open. You are an extremely beautiful girl. And Nila and his dacoit friends often keep moving around here.
Nila? Who is Nila, Kaki?
Nila? A demon. A fierce storm in form of a human. A ghost who shows no mercy. An animal. Who?
Shh. Let's leave from here.
Swami, this jungle is very scary.
Don't worry. In only half an hour, we will reach our home. Come. Swarnalata, run, run.
Oh no. Leave him, leave him. Oh demon.
Nila.
It is my humble prayer that the case of dacoit Nila may be discussed in your majestic presence in urgency.
Yes, Mahamantri ji. Let it be discussed. We have been hearing a lot about his criminal activities.
The Praja is living in fear, Maharaj. Nila is extremely formidable.
And he has gathered around him a crew of particularly dangerous persons. One of his mates has the ability to hide in his own shadow.
In Maharaj, the other has the ability to open any kind of lock or defensive mechanism in a matter of moments. One of them has the ability to silently kill anyone.
One was seen walking on the water, Maharaj.
A blend of indomitable competence and corrupt antisocial motives is going to eat away our kingdom like white ants
if we do not take action immediately.
Do you know his hideout, Senapati?
Just last night we got the information, and therefore we brought this topic for discussion. Please instruct me, Maharaj. I'll go with my army and bring him dead or alive.
No, Senapati ji. I will personally meet him there.
Maharaj, he is a consummate killer, a criminal.
We have heard all that already, Mahamantri. But we have also heard about a lot of talent that he and his friends have.
So, what is your plan, Maharaj?
My plan is to employ him as the tax collector of the district.
What? A decoy as a tax collector? I don't understand this, Maharaj.
These thugs will create damage to our kingdom.
How can we entrust a decoy with the royal wealth, Maharaj? Please forgive me, but I am unable to see any intelligence in this.
When the matter can be sorted out by intelligence, violence can be avoided. If one Nila is killed, there will be another born. If we reform one Nila by addressing his needs, then the evil legacy can be broken.
But what is the guarantee that Nila will be honest and loyal?
Nila may cheat, but then he will be under our vigilance. We can anytime capture him. But if he reforms due to the honor and responsibility given to him, then he and his friends will be cherished assets of our kingdom.
But Maharaj, this meeting can be dangerous.
It can be also fruitful, Maharani.
Maharaj, then please allow Senapati Krishnappa Shetty to accompany you incognito.
All right. Now it's time for my deity's darshan.
You need to improve your speed, Sanappa. The villager ran for at least 2 kilometers before you could chop him off.
It's not about speed, Raka. It's about desire to live. I was running for my daily booty, but he was running for his life. Then I got bored of running, so I killed him.
Nila, where are you running away?
You may all take rest. I am going at the top to see if anyone is passing. Today's catch is not enough. We need more. There is some more running required.
How long will you run in the forest for a few coins, Nila?
Wait! This man knows me. He is here for a purpose. What do you want, brave man? And who are you?
I am the Bhupati, Maharaj Chandrasen.
Nila, we are running into an ambush. Savdhan!
Maharaj, it is not advisable to stand unarmed in front of notorious dacoits. But don't worry, I will not hurt you. You will be saved.
Save me? I have come to save you, Nila. And your friends too.
What do you mean? Maharaj, you are standing in front of Nila. Haven't you heard about my mystic powers?
Raka, get ready. Raghu, it's time to show your prowess. Ramanna.
No one attacks. It is an order. Nila, how long will you run like this?
What do you want, O king?
Stop running and surrender. The post of tax collector of this district is waiting for you. You will have a castle, horses, wealth, servants, and most important, respect. Then why should you run in the forest like a fearful animal?
But why would you give me such an offer?
Because the king is the guardian of his praja. I give you one opportunity to reform yourself and be useful to the kingdom. Think about this, Nila.
He has a point.
Maharaj, your entire army cannot defeat this Nila.
But your offer of employment gives me and my friends a hope of starting new life. Let us sit and discuss the details.
The details will be discussed by me with you, not the king. Come tomorrow in the royal office. Your training starts there.
I had expected this from you, Nila. Very good.
Oh Lord, they will collect taxes? Huh? Didi, when will the glorious Alvar Tirumangai come and reform this wild, wicked, wretched dacoit? Why do you laugh, Didi?
Because the future is yet to unfold, Ladini.
Come here. I want more.
Nila became a tax collector from a dacoit. And so I am becoming a pauper from Sahukar.
The whole kingdom is shocked. I am supposed to submit my tax after 5 days. But I don't want these devilish so-called royal collectors to come to my home. So I come here today itself.
Gone are the days when you used to loot people. The bads have become good and all the thieves and rogues have left the kingdom out of fear.
You are right. The kingdom has become contented. The king is happy. Even Nila is also happy. But the temperament of Nila and his friends has remained the same. All the citizens are terrorized by his cruel nature.
Just see how these rats run, leaving behind their share of cheese.
Why won't they run? When the lion is on the move, the whole forest runs. Who has the audacity to... Aha! What a beauty! I have decided to marry this girl! Hey! Are you her parents?
No.
Well, it's not really in our power to give her to you as a wife, as we are not her parents. But if you want to marry her, if not her parents, At least you should ask her for her opinion.
All right. Call her.
Kemura?
Yes, Kaka ji.
Your Kaka and me are discussing about your marriage, Kemura.
Is it?
And he's considering my proposal. I am Nila, the tax collector of this kingdom. Everyone knows me as a strong, famous and wealthy man.
Oh, so in that case, can you describe some of your qualities?
Of course. Do you see this fist? With one punch, I can knock out 500 people at a time.
Really? How wonderful!
So, do you agree for my marriage proposal?
You are a royal minister, a strong, famous and a wealthy man, filled with so many qualities. How can any girl refuse you? But
what?
But I have decided to marry only to a Vaishnav.
Vaishnav? Can a Vaishnav knock out more than 500 people at a time?
No. Vaishnavas are the devotees of the Lord. They are found in temples.
Devotees? Temple? So if I become a devotee, you will marry me?
So will you become a devotee for me?
Oh! Devotee? I can even become a devil for you. You just wait here. I will immediately become a devotee and come back to you. Hey, Pujari! Come here!
Son, have you lost your way today? This is temple, beta. People come here to worship.
Shut up! I don't have much time. Make me a Vaishnav.
What?
Make me a Vaishnav, you fool! Have you gone deaf?
Oh yes. Hey, Vaishnava. Just a minute. What is this test, O Lord? You want me to make him devotee? Why not light a fire in the water? Why not teach fish to fly high in the sky? Why not make the sun rise from the west? Why do you always get funny ideas, O Lord?
Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat पूर्णमुदच्छते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादय पूर्णम् एव वशिष्यते. So now you are a Vaishnava. Go.
What? You mean I have become a Vaishnava?
Of course. Ask him. Hey, hasn't he become a Vaishnava?
But
how can he say no?
I'm a Vaishnava. I'm a Vaishnava now. Kemuda,
listen carefully. Again you try that prank on me, I will leave your service.
Kemuda.
What?
I have become a Vaishnava. Hey, why do you laugh? The pujari said so. If the pujari has lied to me, I'll break his bones.
No. Pujari is right. With this tilak and this garland of the Lord, now you're looking exactly like a Vaishnav. Wow. But
what? Kemuda, you tell me without any hesitation. I can do anything for you.
Really? Can you do anything for me?
I swear on Ma Kali, I can do anything. You just speak out.
Listen, Nila. This garland and this tilak, all these are the signs of a devotee, but not the proof.
So tell me, Kemuda, what are the symptoms of a devotee? What proof do you want to be convinced that I am a Vaishnav?
For 1 year, you should invite 1,000 Vaishnavas every day. Wash their feet, drink that water, feed them sumptuously. If you can do this, then I will be convinced that you have become a Vaishnav.
1,000 Vaishnavas, washing their feet, drinking that water, feeding them sumptuously, 1 full year, every day. Is that all? You just watch, Kemuda, how I qualify as a Vaishnav. Friends, go and catch hold of each and every Vaishnav in the kingdom and get them into my courtyard. And note, the number should not be less than 1,000.
Surely, my friend. Then tell me, what have we to do?
No. We have to wash their feet, drink that water, and feed them sumptuously.
Is your health okay?
Just do what I say. Now your Nila is becoming a Vaishnav, Sanappa.
All right, my friend. If you so desire, we will catch each and every Vaishnav in the kingdom and bring him to you. Let's go, friends. Hey, you are wearing a tilak. Are you a Vaishnav?
Yes, sir. I do japa every day. I don't trouble anyone, sir. I'm a Vaishnav.
Come on, take him.
Hey, you, come here.
Ranganath, you save me.
Sanappa, take him.
Govinda.
Nila, if you are about to cut his leg, why do you wash it? Cut it just like that.
Hey, I'm not cutting it. I'm washing his feet so that I can have his charanamrit.
In this way, there were miraculous changes in the life of this dacoit Nila. From a dacoit, he became a tax collector. From a tax collector, he became a friend of Kemuda. And now, he's trying to become a Vaishnav.
Didi, don't tell me that the same Nila becomes the glorious Alvar, Tirumangai.
You must be thinking, how can a wicked man's temperament change to such a degree? But that is the glory of Vaishnav association. That is the glory of serving Vaishnavas, Ladini. We should take this lesson that when someone is trying to become a Vaishnav, then we should overlook his present disturbing temperaments, his behavior, his way of talking. Of course it is wrong. What is the hope of deliverance of such a person? But if he is engaged in the service of Vaishnavas, then he will surely become a Vaishnav one day, Ladini.
But till then, Didi, what should we do?
Forgive, tolerate, and offer respect. Ladini, our acharyas say, Vaishnavism is beyond right and wrong. Look at these sweet Vaishnavas. How they are helping Nila to become a Vaishnav. By their grace, after 6 months, Nila starts manifesting Vaishnav qualities.
Welcome, Prabhu. I thank you from the bottom of my heart to come and purify my home, my life, my existence.
Nila, your transformation has brought about a great mood of devotion and feeling of protection in the entire kingdom. We must thank you.
I have received the real purpose of my life, Vaishnav Seva. Hearing to your Bhagavad Kathas, it's like drowning in an ocean of bliss.
Please take your seat here and honor Prasad.
Kaka, you haven't taken much Prasad in your plate. Let me serve you with my own hands.
No, Nila. I have had enough already today.
My inappropriate behavior in the past with you is still holding you from forgiving me, isn't it, Kaka? I don't know how I could behave in such a rude manner with you. Please forgive my offenses, Kaka. I feel so ashamed.
Oh, Nila, this is probably the 100 times you have expressed your repentance and begged apology. I am fed up of forgiving you.
If it is so, then let me be convinced of that. Please take one more roti from my hands, please.
Sanappa, 1 year has already passed. Nila has forgotten that he had to marry that beautiful girl, Kemuda. He is so engrossed in Vaishnav Seva, so much, that no other pleasure of this world attracts him in life anymore.
Yes. It has become his paramadharma, his life and soul. But Raka, just like everything of this world comes to an end, Nila's wealth has also ended due to opulent services.
We need to make him aware of it.
Nila, we are proud of you today. You have used every penny of yours in the service of Vaishnavas. You have started living like a mendicant in a hut and begging food for yourself. No one would believe if they are told that this huge project was funded by you.
Was funded? What do you mean, Raka? I funded, I am funding, and I will fund it. This is not going to stop.
Nila, you know our wealth is over.
So? It will come. Have faith. Haven't you heard in the class?
Nila, we should act seeing the present situations. And the present conditions are forcing us to stop Vaishnav Seva.
No! Vaishnav Seva will not stop. Your breaths may if you repeat it again.
Nila, try to understand. We all want to serve Vaishnavas, but how to do it? Thousands have prasad here every day. Where is the stuff going to come from after a month? How are we going to pay the bills?
We have the royal treasure in which we deposit the tax of the kingdom.
But that is royal wealth.
It belongs to the king.
It belongs to the citizens. And what is wrong in using it for the service of the Vaishnavas?
But Nila...
Enough! Just do what I tell you. Vaishnav Seva doesn't stop.
What? Nila is using the royal treasure for opulent charities without my approval?
This is misuse of independence, Your Majesty. It is an unpardonable crime. My request is that you must announce a strict action against Nila as an example for future lawbreakers.
Capture Nila!
And bring him here at once.
Let the Garuda regiment of King's army march tomorrow to capture Nila.
Maharaj, by the prowess of his mystical power, Nila sent back every soldier wounded and defeated.
So much arrogance!
I will personally go and bind the traitor. You were right, Mahamantri. He has insulted my compassionate gesture towards him. Now he will see my wrath.
Maharaj, forgive me, but one person defeating an entire regiment? This appears supernatural. We know about his mystical powers, so we have to be thoroughly prepared also.
Yes. I order the entire army of our kingdom to march towards Nila's castle. Let me see how Nila uses his mystical powers against the entire kingdom's army.
In great anger, the king marched upon Nila. But Nila defeated the entire army single-handedly. Everyone was shocked at the prowess of Nila. In the end, the king was brought down on the ground with Nila's sword at the king's neck.
Maharaj! Up till now, the wealth that I have used from the royal treasure is a loan to me from you. I will return it to you in future. Agreed?
All right.
Nila! Instead of serving the king who gave you employment and honor, you are humiliating him?
But Kaka, he attacked me with his entire army.
He was only implementing the law. You have broken the law. Only the king has the authority over the royal treasure.
But I was using the wealth for Vaishnav Seva. Vaishnavas are the devotees of the Lord.
And king is the representative of God. So, it is your duty to obey him, not humiliating him like this. This is an offense.
If in your opinion, this is an offense, Then I surrender myself to the king. O king, whatever punishment you decide for me now, I am ready to face.
The man who could not be defeated by an entire army got defeated by the chastisement of a Vaishnav? You are an extraordinary devotee, Nila. I misunderstood you.
O King, yesterday the Lord spoke to me in my dream that at the border of this country, under a banyan tree, there is profuse wealth arranged by Him. He told me to dig it out, repay your liability, and do Vaishnav Seva from the remaining wealth. I am not sure whether it was just a dream or reality.
So, let us find out the reality.
Immediately send workers to dig that place.
Maharaj, there is a great amount of wealth found at the place shown by Tirumangai.
As the Lord instructed, half of it belongs to you, Maharaj.
No, Nila, no. Now I have realized that you are not an ordinary man, a person whose liability is repaid by the Lord Himself, can be only a great devotee of the Lord.
Tirumangai Alvar ki Jai!
Nila, you have done a lot of service to the Vaishnavas, year after year, till today. Now you don't need to do it anymore.
Need? Raka, it is not my need, but it is my life and soul. I can't live without serving the Vaishnavas. Vaishnav Seva never stops. It will never stop.
But what can you do? For serving, you need wealth. And where are you going to get it from? You are no more a tax collector. You do not have any business skills. The wealth given by the Lord is also over. All your life, you have done only stealing and dacoity.
All right then. We will do stealing and dacoity.
What? You will do stealing and dacoity to do Vaishnav Seva?
You said it. I cannot do anything else, can I? So I have no choice. I will loot the wealthy people who cheat the king and exploit the innocent citizens.
But Nila, all these years you have changed yourself just to please Vaishnavas. You have gained so much punya.
I am not interested in pap and punya. I just know that Vaishnav Seva is param dharma.
So let's get back to our old profession. We will loot the wealthy cheaters at night, who exploit the poor, and do the Vaishnav Seva during day.
The Lord has personally instructed me to steal the forms of Buddha made of gold and use that gold for Vaishnav Seva. Let the Lord be pleased in this inconceivable way. We loot, but we use all the booty only for serving the Lord and the Vaishnavas. Remember, no one will keep anything for himself. We are in service, not in crime.
But Nila, this Buddha's murti is very huge and protected by expert system. How are we going to dislodge it and carry it to Sri Rangam?
You all are not ordinary either, Raghu. Friends, each one of you are blessed by mystic powers. You all can do it. Just think how wonderful the canopy of gold look above our beloved Lord Ranganath.
Yes, it will indeed be a great offering to the Lord.
Jai Ranganath!
I will guard outside until you do the job. Now go. We have to escape before dawn.
The Buddhist then went to the king and complained. The king was in a difficult situation, having to deal with Nila again. He called Nila and requested him to return the murti. Thirumangai said, "Don't worry. In 2 weeks I'll return this murti to you. Not less than a finger." Everyone was happy.
So did he return the deities back to them?
When the Buddhists met Nila, they only saw Nila and his men there and no murti. When they asked him, "Well, where is our murti?" Nila reached into his pocket and pulled out a finger, a golden finger. "Here it is," he said, "not less than a finger." The Buddhist monks were incensed, and again there was a big fight. But Nila defeated them all.
But Didi, isn't it a crime to steal?
Of course it is, Ladini. But not when the Lord is pleased by our actions. Whatever Thirumangai did, pleased the Lord.
But what if people start following Thirumangai and start looting people?
I challenge them, Ladini. I challenge them. If anyone can do what Thirumangai did, then yes, looting people will also liberate them.
But...
just watch, Ladini. Just watch. This is the proof of the purity of Thirumangai. Can anyone imitate this?
Nila, it's the end of our thirst for wealth. Many bullock carts, all filled with gold ornaments, are coming in our direction.
They must be at least 50.
I have never seen so much wealth in my whole life.
How many soldiers?
Surprisingly none.
How can that be? Such great wealth without escort?
Believe me, Nila, there are only two of them, husband and wife.
So we don't have to do any dacoity again in life after this. It's an easy job. The Lord's arrangement. Go, take positions. Stop! Do you know me?
Yes, you are Nila.
Then you should know why I stand before you.
You want my wealth, right?
Not just the ones in the bullock carts. I want all the ornaments that you wear on yourself also. Hey, why are you smiling?
No, you carry on your work.
Nila removed all of the ornaments from the jeweler and his wife. But in the end, the toe ring of the jeweler's wife wouldn't come out. Nila applied his full strength, but failed. Then he tried to remove it with his teeth. At that time, the dust from her feet entered Nila's mouth.
What? What is happening to me? What is this ecstasy? My hair is standing on end. My entire body is shaking. I was never so happy. Tears are flowing incessantly from my eyes. I'm experiencing extraordinary bliss. Who are you? Who are you both? Please tell me.
Nila, you do not recognize me. You have served my devotees all these years with so much of love and devotion.
Bhagwan Narayan, Mother Lakshmi,
What a blessed day it is today. To have your darshan, the devotees have done millions of austerities in the past. And I am receiving the same without qualification. Thank you, O Lord. Thank you a million times.
Now, please allow me to leave. I have an important service.
But what can be more important than meeting the Lord who has come to see you?
And where are you taking my ornaments and Lakshmi's ornaments also?
O Lord, please forgive me. I have service to Vaishnavas and I need these ornaments for their service.
For the service of my devotees, you steal my ornaments? You did not spare even me, Nila?
I'm sorry, my Lord. I'm sorry. But your devotees are very sweet. I can't see them even slightly unhappy.
But you will have to go to hell for a long time for this theft of the Lord's ornaments, Nila.
Yes. Yes, I understand, Mother. It's all right. I'm ashamed, but also helpless. Nothing is more important to me than Vaishnav Seva.
Wait, Nila, for the pleasure of my devotees, you are robbing me today. You don't even spare me? Nila, oh Nila, you don't know how much pleasure you are giving to my heart. You are truly blessed. You are the recipient of the essence of all knowledge. One who calls himself my servant is not my servant. One who calls himself the servant of my servant is my true servant.
The Lakshmi Sampradaya started when Nila was taking the ring from the lotus toe of Sri Lakshmiji. Sripad Ramanujacharya later established this Lakshmi Sampradaya with Siddhanta. But the devotional line actually starts here. Alvar Thirumangai is thus the Acharya who established the main Siddhanta of Sri Sampradaya, that is, Vaishnav Seva.
Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,
RG Media YouTube channel. Like, share, subscribe.